Hi, so for the first part of our Massing and Area Studies course, we're going to look at how we can create a building volume from a set of setbacks and cut floor plates at given heights to reach an estimate of the total area that we can develop here, as well as the yield, which is how many times the area of the site can be developed. So I've already got my context model set up here. And this blue outline is the site. What I've also gone ahead and done is set up the setbacks required by local regulations. What we're going to do is turn these into 2D planes. And I've already done this in a layer called setbacks. And you want to write this down exactly as it's written here, setbacks in capitals, because we're going to reference this layer into Grasshopper to load these automatically. So the first part is quite easy, just taking the vertical setbacks and extruding them up. And you also want to add a cap at the bottom, because the idea is to generate a volume from all of these. Now there are also some diagonal setbacks, which are these, which start at the opposite curb. And after you've drawn in all of the setbacks required, this should be enough to create a closed volume from all of these. So let's just load Grasshopper. And the first thing that we're going to do is create a geometry pipeline component. This will load geometry from a given layer in Rhino directly into Grasshopper. So under layer, we just have to write down the layer name, which is setbacks, and double click on the type of geometry, which would be BREP. And you can see all of these planes are already loaded into Grasshopper. What we can do now is create a boundary volume component, which will take all of these planes and simply create a volume based on what's inside all of them, based on what they enclose. And we can stop previewing the imported geometry, and we get the volume which we can build inside. Now, because this is referenced directly, if I want to change anything about this volume, I just have to move the planes within Grasshopper. Say if I want the setback on this side to be 5 meters instead of 3, all I have to do is take this and move it 2 meters. And the volume is updated. The next thing we want to do is cut floor plates. So we can find out what the total area that can be developed within this volume is. We'll do that by defining planes at specific heights. And we'll need a list of heights at each floor. An easy way to do this is to create the floor height that you want as an input. Say we want 2 floor heights. The first 2 floors are going to be at 4.5, and the rest are going to be at 3 meters. So we're going to want a slider here that corresponds to 2, because you want two floor heights at 4.5. And another one here which corresponds to 2. The number of floors which you want for 3 meters. Now we just need to create a list of these. So we'll duplicate 4.5 twice. And we'll duplicate 3 16 times. So that's 2 4.5s. And 16 threes. We want to add these all into a list. We'll do that using the merge component. But also we want to start with our starting height, which we'll define as 0. So it will start at level 0, and it'll start adding 4.5, 4.5, and 3, and 3, and 3, and 3. So we just merge all of these into a list. It'll usually give you some problems matching up the branches in merge, so you probably want to flatten them all. To get a single list. And in order to make these add progressively, we can use the addition component, mass addition, and this gives you two outputs. One of them, which was the addition of all the items in this list, which we're not interested in, but it also gives us a partial results list, which is a progressive addition, which means it starts at 0, then adds 4.5, then adds 4.5 to that, which is 9, and then adds 3 and 3 and 3. And that's our list of levels. What we want to do now is use these to define an origin for a set of planes, which are perpendicular to the XY. So that's this one. And this asks for an origin. So we need to create a set of points from these. So we'll go to the construct point component, insert these as a Z value, so the height. And you can see these at the origin. So that's 4.5, 4.5, and the rest are 3. So we can use that to create our planes. There they are. And what we'll do next is intersect the volume with planes. And that's BREP plane section under the intersect options. So our volume would be here, and the set of planes which you would be using to cut it would be here. And that should be cutting floor plates from this volume. And you can see that the floor heights are maintained. If you make your volume extend below ground, you can start not at 0, but at a basement level of your choice. Also, you can add more levels at 4.5, or less, or 0. And if you wanted to add an intermediate level, then you'd create another set of numbers, merge those, and then that would be inserted into the list. But let's keep just these for now. Before we begin to add all of these up, you'll notice that some of these floor plates aren't really very useful. usually you'll have a minimum floor plate size which is considered viable for development. So what we want to do is find these areas using the area component. And each curve will be plugged into that. This also finds the centroid of every floor plate polygon, which is useful as well. And we want to know which of these are larger than a specified number. Say 300 square meters. We don't want anything smaller than that. So we use that to filter through this list. And see, it will have removed every curve that's below this number. Now that we have this list, we can get a total using the mass addition again. Oops, I was filtering out. This is actually the curves that I was filtering out. See, because that's connected to the curves. You also want to filter out the area numbers and add those together. And you'll have to flatten this because they're all on separate branches. Since it's areas, you also want to probably make it into an integer. And you'll get a readout for the total area that can be developed. Call this total. Now we can also calculate the yield, which is a really useful measure, which is how many times the plot size can be developed in terms of area in the building. So we'll need to insert a curve, which is our site boundary. So let's do that. That's this blue one. Read the area of this with the area component. And divide the total by this number. This should give us the yield. Which is 8.4, quite decent. Now, since this is parametric, whenever you change, for example, the floor height, say from a 3.0 to 3.5 for the later levels, increase the number of floors with a 4.5 height, these numbers will update and you'll get a smaller yield and smaller total area. The same applies to the area cutoff. So this is quite useful as an initial study to be able to look at the development potential of a site based on setbacks and floor heights.